cooperation of our entire audience in a couple areas. Firstly, although we understand you're thrilled about your family member or friend graduating, we ask that you refrain from cheering or applause at the time an individual's name is called. The reason is that when this happens, the next person does not have the opportunity to have their name heard, nor does their family have the opportunity to have their full moment of pride. Please hold your applause until all students have been honored. Concerning pictures, we do have an official photographer. The audience desk cannot stand in the front of the parent section during the graduation ceremony. You will be notified later about receiving the photograph. Also, since this is the last time that the group will be together as a class, we ask that they be allowed to complete the recessional at the end of the ceremony. Security will help parents and friends know what area in the back needs to remain clear and allow students to walk out. Thank you for cooperating.
Contribution in the whole human family. May they love whatever is just and true and good, even as you have loved. To you alone, Lord, be the glory through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Superintendent Dr. Lewis Finch, Reverend Dan Seidelman, School Board Member Dr. John Stonecat, Chairperson of the School Board Dr. Larry Ragland, Assistant Principal Joel Carolat, Acting Dean Dan Denneke, our Principal Ann Weber, and myself, Senior Class President Marty Manson.
Violence they commit on minorities and to say that is wrong, but How many of us will move out when the minority families move into our neighborhood? Just as it is easy for our school to tell us to seize the day while teaching us what is really important, to make money, to follow, to be good, passive citizens who do not question old truths of how life has to be. Things like dress code, poverty, hunger, and nuclear bombs. I have never heard the establishment as a whole, be it government, schools, or the media, endorse the true spirit of carpe diem. I think that we should teach our children to gather the rosebuds where they may, instead of what we presently teach, which seems to run more like rosebuds are fine when you have time for them. You can pick rosebuds on your vacation or when you retire, if you live that long. Shouldn't we teach our children love and kindness rather than materialism?